Hello, and thank you for taking the time to join in for this conversation regarding our recently published work in the Journal of the American College of Surgeons. In this, we looked at rates of women as authors of randomized controlled trials and minimally invasive surgical approaches, utilizing systematic review and a meta-analysis of over three decades worth of surgical research. I am indebted to the contributions of each of my co-authors and really thank them for contributing to this work. As you can see here, utilizing this visual abstract, we looked at just under 500 randomized controlled trials published over the last 30 years. Among these nearly 500 trials, women were first authors in under 14% and senior authors in just over 12%. And clearly, as one might expect, there was some significant variation between surgical specialties, with the highest representation of women as first or last authors in obstetrics and gynecology, although this barely reached a quarter of these authorship positions. However, there is some room, I think, for optimism. We do see increasing rates of women in important authorship positions on these trials over time. And so if you look at the three decades captured in the study, certainly things have improved, I think. And if we look at this in a little bit different way, looking at rates year over year, we do see a trend for improvement, both in first, last, and the combined authorship metrics. So taking this together, I think we can be reassured that there has been a significant increase among women as first and last authors among RCTs and surgery. And this is important as these represent the highest quality data to guide our practice. However, women remain the minority of authors, and disproportionately so when compared to the surgical workforce. So even accounting for specialties where women are relatively poorly represented, we still see that at the upper echelons of surgical research, women are even further underrepresented. And so I think overall, the medical world has done a fairly good job of characterizing issues in terms of disparities for both our patients and within our medical workforce. So now we need to take the next step. We need to move from writing about and describing these problems to addressing them. And so I would encourage each and every one of you to take some time and contemplate how you, at an individual level, at a departmental level, and an institutional level, can make the academic world more amenable to the contributions of our female colleagues. The diversity of opinion that we get when we broaden the workforce really enriches the quality of the research we do and improves care for our patients. So please take a moment and consider how you as an individual can help make our surgical workforce and the academic contributions of our workforce a more diverse and inclusive place. Thanks again for taking the time, and I hope this has sparked some interest for you.